Hey everybody, Paul Gray here. Thank you for joining me today for our third edition of Metanoia Mindset Moments. I'm having fun sharing some things with you that I hope are very helpful, and some of you have told me that they are, so I'm grateful for that. Sure appreciate your comments and your being in touch with me. Metanoia, of course, is the Greek word that was used when the New Testament was being written, and it means to change your mind, to have a radical mindset change. And we need that today because we have some wrong mindsets about different things. We know about identity theft, and my friend Don Keithley had a great teaching last Sunday. So I'm recording this, that was March 22nd. He had a great teaching on identity theft. And there are evil forces, dark forces, however you picture them or view them, that want to steal our identity and use it for evil gain. Well, there are dark forces, similarly, that have done a real number on stealing God's identity. Now, they haven't stole it from him, but what they've done is they've done a number in our mindset of stealing the true identity of God and getting us to believe some false things about God. And what we believe about God affects everything in our life. So that's kind of what we're doing in this little short series. So here's our mindset today. The only true God, as Jesus calls his papa, wants us to have absolute, complete, and total assurance. Assurance that we are right with them, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that they love us, that they're for us, that their grace has taken care of everything in our relationship. They want us to absolutely know that everything is all right between us and them. The view of a fictitious evil God that many people have been taught to believe in encompasses no assurance and great doubt. With that false God, you never know if you've done enough to please him. You never know if he's mad at you. You never know if there's something else that you haven't done or have done that's going to upset him. And there's always great doubt. Have I done enough? Can I do enough? Does he like me today or not? That's not the only true God. And along with that same concept, the only true God, Jesus Papa, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, want us to have a righteousness conscious, confident that we have already been made right with them by them, not by anything that we've done in our own ability, not even for asking for it. But Scripture tells us that at the cross, God the Father was in Christ Jesus reconciling everyone forever to God, not counting anyone's sins against us. Jesus took our sins off of us, took them away from us, and gave us his righteousness, his right standing with God. They literally made us new creations that are just right for them. Now, the fictitious evil God mindset wants us to think that God wants us to have a sin consciousness. And boy, that mindset has really impacted the church, the religious institutions, because in many churches, every Sunday you go and the pastor, who's well-meaning, but I believe very misinformed and still has a mindset of a fictitious evil God, will stand up and say, there's sin here. You have sin. Here's the problem. Here's what you need to do to rectify that. But you need to focus on your sin and then change that, and so that you can get right with God. That's an evil, fictitious God mindset. God wants us literally to have no sin consciousness, but to know that we are already perfectly right with him. Now, here's the third thing I want to talk about today. The only true God, Jesus Papa, wants us to absolutely know that God has no expectations of us. Now, that might seem very weird to you because I was brought up, you probably were too, that God's got all kinds of expectations of us and they're impossible expectations. No, think about it. God is omniscient. God knows everything. He knows what we're going to say before we say it. He knows what we're going to do today, tomorrow, the next day. Why would he possibly expect us to do something or not do something that he already knows is going to happen. Do you get that? See, God knows exactly when we're going to come to the understanding and the belief of what is already true, that God is unconditional love. He loves us and everyone. He's already made everything right with us. He's included all of us. God knows the exact moment when that's going to happen. That may be in this life. That may be after we take our last breath here. It may be sometime in the future. But God knows when that is and when that's going to happen. So God has no expectations of us coming to that point or change, modifying our behavior or whatever anytime between now and then. All right? The impossible, the fictitious evil God, though, we have come to believe has impossible expectations of us that, of course, we can never met, never meet, but we've got to try really hard to do that and then heap guilt on ourselves and experience God's condemnation when we don't meet those expectations. This probably is something new for some of you to hear, so I really appreciate you to take some time today, think about these things, play this again, listen to it if you need to, meditate about them, go to God and say, God, show me, Holy Spirit, Christ in me, show me whether or not these things are true, whether I've had a false mindset or not, and then listen and take sides with God. Ask for his revelation and then believe it. Now, as we talk about the only true God and the fictitious evil God, I want to ask you, which of these two gods can you love? Which do you long to be with? Which do you want to be around? Which do you feel comfortable with? Which is awesome and winsome and inviting? Which resonates with your heart and your spirit? Which makes you happy? Which do you want to be true? Which seems to be love and mercy and grace and compassion? Which seems to be like Jesus? Which one do you want to tell your friends about? All right, everybody, thanks for being with me. Hope this has been helpful. See you next time. Love you all.